Hi, my name is Hope, and I'm a product designer at Treehouse. In this course, I'll teach you about interaction design, which is commonly abbreviated as IXD. We'll take a look at the theories and then apply them practically in a design program. First up, what is interaction design? Well, it's a subset of user experience. While user experience is a comprehensive look at the entire user journey, interaction design focuses on the interactive experience. Let's take a look at how John Kolko, the author of Thoughts on Interaction Design, defines it. Interaction design is the creation of a dialogue between a person and a product, system, or service. The dialogue is both physical and emotional in nature, and is manifested in the interplay between form, function, and technology as experienced over time. You can think of it as the relationship between a person and a product. As people interact with the product, there's a back and forth conversation. In the book, Designing Interfaces, the authors describe the exchange of information between the person and the software. The person expects continuous feedback that their actions are being acted upon and their needs are being met. This feedback loop forms a substantial part of the user experience. Generally, we want to make that conversation as smooth as possible. In the 90s, researchers at Stanford University discovered that people tend to treat computers as if they were either real people or real places. This is called the media equation. Following that logic, humans expect digital products to be human-like. As designers, we want to create a natural, human-like conversation, anticipate needs, and exceed expectations. Think of a time you were mad at your computer for shutting down unexpectedly, or a time a printer continuously claimed there was a paper jam that you just couldn't find, and then spontaneously started printing after you simply jiggled the paper tray a bit. You probably got annoyed. How rude of the printer to behave like that. When products fail us, we have an emotional response. It's as if the inanimate object has broken our trust, and our relationship with it is fractured. It's moments like these where the fundamentals of interaction design enable us to empathize with the user and preemptively design solutions that prevent frustration and broken trust. In the next video, I'll introduce the five dimensions that form the foundation of interaction design.